Today's February 24th, 2017, and it's a Friday, and you know what that means. You're Juan Najarian's going to the airport for another, after a busy week up in New York.
Yeah, yeah. Luckily, flying back private today, so that's a blessing.
Yeah.
It was a good week, productive week. How'd you like that Restoration Hardware's trade, Andrew? Did you have any of that?
Nah, I'm not. I haven't been trading as of late. I just have the positions that I have. I'm
gonna
listen out. I mean, I have. I don't know. I've been busy doing stuff, getting better at video, working on that. But no, you had that call. You nailed it.
Yeah, we got lucky. Unusual activity, and then when I was looking around, and the judge, you know, Scott Wapner, was asking us, "God, where are you guys seeing any value these days? You know, everything's so expensive." And I said, "Really?" Ralph Lauren. We bought that at 77 or whatever. Restoration Hardware in the low 20s. How are these not values? You know, of course, if there's things that you don't know, for instance, you know, malfeasance or some sort of scandal or whatever else, but it's not likely that either of those two companies, as many years as they've been around, are experiencing either of those. So they could have an earnings shortfall, they could have a warning, and they could get hurt by a border adjustment tax, I guess. But other than that, they seemed awfully cheap. And certainly that popped 28% today out of Restoration Hardware, Andrew.
Okay, I think we need to slow down here for our listeners, because we get a lot of questions like, "What, you know, you talk so much about this and that, and we don't know." Explain to everyone what the border adjustment tax is and how it's affecting these stocks and why. Like, pretend you're looking at a tweet. Real easy stuff.
All right, I'll try to keep it up. Probably not 140 characters, but border adjustment tax is, as the president has said, he wants to adjust our trade agreements so that American workers are not at a disadvantage. One way to do that is to negotiate that, well, if you're competing against somebody who makes on the other side of the border, wherever that border is, let's just refer to it universally. It's not just against Mexico, could be against China, Vietnam, Pakistan, you know, where a lot of the retail goods are put together and then shipped to us. So if some of these guys have very low wages, it's pretty unfair for the competition. And the president has said that, well, we might have to have a border adjustment tax. Certainly the Democrats want that. I'm sorry. The Republicans in the House have been pushing for that. And Gary Cohen, the president's advisor from Goldman Sachs, has said he does not support that. So in other words, for those rooting for a trade war, it doesn't look like they're going to get it. But yeah, that kind of thing, Andrew, that border adjustment tax, unless it's negotiated with some other items, could have resulted in a lot of higher prices for retailers that they'd have to pass on to the American consumer, or a trade war, one or the other.
Now, you tweeted out two stocks that got hit. One was Dollar Tree, and what was the other one? There's one other one.
Let's see, Dollar Tree and Five, F-I-V-E.
Why would they
were two of?
Why would they get hurt?
Well, they were hurt by, because so much of what they sell, just like Walmart,
junk.
So much of what Walmart sells, so
stores
is
that sell
coming
junk.
In. Well, your words, not mine.
I know. I'll take ownership
but,
of that because it is junk.
All right.
Crap.
But they sell that stuff, and it might not be on the high end. It might be very value priced, and they're frequently getting that from on the other side of the border. Again, a whole host of borders, not just with Mexico. Could even be from Canada.
So those stores might have to pay a little bit more for that dollar junk.
Right. If indeed a border tax or BAT went in. seems like the president's advisor, Mr. Cohen, is pushing back against that and back against the Republicans in the House that want it. And so immediately we saw a reaction in FIVE and Dollar Tree DLTR. But, you know, there are dozens and dozens of retailers, in particular clothing and so forth, that would react immediately to either the imposition, imposing that border tax, or to the idea that, nope, just something we talked about, we're not going to do it.
Okay. Now, what else are we looking at today?
Let's see. New skin, NUS.
I saw that.
There were a lot of puts in there. Yeah, that
NUS
was kind of interesting. Yep, it's a direct seller to consumers.
Multi-level marketing.
Like, you know, sort of like Avon, right?
MLM.
Or famously Herbalife.
I know.
Legally, but multi-level marketers,
sure.
Yes.
I like
this. And direct sellers. And in this one, the stock fell from like 55 to 46, I think, just within the last month, and has been stabilizing and trying to make a bounce back. And as it has done that, today all of a sudden it just saw a surge of 6% and took it back over 50 to, I think, 52 and change, Andrew, from like 48 and change yesterday. And so
they're buying, right?
Yeah, instead of either people chasing in and saying, boy, it looks like it might get right back to the old highs, as soon as it popped like this, they bought a lot of puts. And we checked. They didn't buy stock with those puts. So they either already had the stock, that's a possibility, or they decided they wanted these puts, which is kind of funky because these puts were not cheap. They were $4.60. And, you know, you divide 460 by 52 or whatever, you get, you know, that this was a 6.5-7% of the stock price in those puts. In other words, so you're dragging that put along with you for protection, but the next 6 or 7% out of the stock, you don't get it. It basically pays for the put. So in other words, if you see 7% more of upside, okay, you're doing well on your stock, but and the put goes out worthless. It ate up all the profit of the next 7%. So it would be more interesting and more bullish, in my opinion, if they were sellers of calls against a long stock position, because now they have the upside and they're going to play it that way. But with this, boy, it eats up most of your upside.
Some listeners might have to rewind that to listen to that twice, but it is good information. Can I tell you a funny Newskin story?
Please.
Okay. So I was part of the Newskin cult for...
were you?
Oh, yeah. Okay. Yeah. Well, my girlfriend was. So we went to Utah. We went to one of their conventions. This is like when it first started. It was like some of their original guys. You know, we were all like, wow, this is great. So one of the guys, Craig something, he's one of the founders. I'm sure he's still there if he's not dead. But he had a party out of his house in, I believe, like Orem, someplace in Utah. That's where they're based. And he had a little party in his house. And I'm like, oh, this is cool, man. This is what you get when you get like $1 million a month, you know, in checks, you know. You know, become the blue diamond. New skin person, you know, sitting at the house. So, of course, I'm interested. I'm thinking, what does this guy listen to as far as music goes? And this is like the 90s, right? So I look at his CD collection. And I'm looking at his CDs, and guess what kind of CDs he has?
Grateful Dead?
No, you wish. Every one of them, he had like 15 Yanni CDs.
Oh, no.
Yeah, Yanni. Like, if one album wasn't enough, he had them all.
Oh,
and
gosh.
He was playing them. And I'm like, wow, man, Yanni, cool. He kind of looked like Yanni himself, but I never forget that. I was like in Utah listening to Yanni at a new skin party.
Well, now you got to lay a Yanni bed underneath this podcast.
Can I find it? Actually, I saw Yanni in concert. Some girl I knew took me to a concert. He was kind of like really, it's really Yanni. That was the... That's my new skin story. Actually, I got more new skin stories, but that was one of the funnier ones that I thought. All right, well, I'll let you
that
go.
That is a funny one. All right. Well, remember, folks, you can subscribe to the podcast and get it an alert every time we have a new one, either through YouTube or iTunes. And share it with a friend. Why not?